Five. Ladies and gentlemen, if you thought that I will not make this particular Fight Night broadcast, you are fucking wrong. We're gonna do UFC Fight Night 95 for sure, because Cris Cyborg Justino is in the house. She's a destroyer and she'll be fighting later tonight. But first up, let me give you a quick update on what the fuck is happening in UFC Fight Night 95, Cyborg versus Lansberg. It's been a really pathetic night of fights, to be honest with you people. It's pretty pathetic. But what to do? Gotta do what you gotta do, right? Most of the fights have been decisions. But thankfully, the first fight of the main card just got over. And Godfredo Pepe got a beautiful finish in round one via rear naked choke. Let me update the stream details. Give me a second. If you are watching this from any of these locations, hopefully you can see this. There are some channels which I highlighted on the screen. If you're in Russia, you can watch this on NTV Plus or Match TV. If you're in Sweden, you can watch this on TV3, TV10, Viasat Sport, Viaplay, and all these other channels which I've highlighted. If you're in the USA, you can watch this on Fight or Fox Deportes. Hopefully you can hear me. If you are in India, you can watch this on Sony ESPN, Sony ESPN HD, Philippines, Hyper TV, South Korea, SPO TV. Let us check who's joining us in the channel. Man, last Fight Night was pretty awesome though. Last Fight Night was fucking awesome. I loved it. Michael Johnson versus Dustin Poirier. The coming out fight is Thiago Santos was Eric Spicely. Santos is 32, Spicely is 29. Santos is taller, has more reach. Let us have a look and see what the hell is happening with the stream. Nobody is watching. Very nice. It's time to change the thumbnail. Hopefully we got it right now. Beautiful Jenny Andrade. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu brown belt is Eric Spicely. Here we go, round one. Santos is in the yellow trunks, Spicely in the blue. Santos is a striker, Spicely is a ground fighter going for the ground game from the beginning. Beautifully defended by Maheta Santos. Nice work. Let us see where the fuck is the... Oh my fucking god. Yeah, Cyborg's here. Fucking Cyborg. Motherfuckers. Yeah, still no one's watching because nobody is clicking. The timings are fucking weird. Let me change the fucking timing. Okay, so round one progressing as usual. Looking pretty normal. Oh, it's Taddy, new page name. Okay. JT's hunting and fishing. Okay, Taddy Daddy. I feel you. Welcome back. Oh, looks like a partial armbar. Thiago Santos does not want any of that. For sure. Taddy Daddy is the first watcher of today's fight night. Which is great. Oh my god, Eric Spicely is going for the takedowns, man. Oh, beautiful trip takedown by Eric Spicely. Nice transitions. Very good. Very good. Shout out to JT's hunting and fishing. Tati Daddy, hopefully you can hear the audio reasonably well. 99% of the world's population is pretty much sleeping right now. But it's early morning here in my location. And Eric Spicely seems to be doing a reasonably good job. He's trying to go for a Kimura, I think. Oh, he's going for mount. Okay, Maheta Santos. His ground game looks stupid today. Thiago Santos, remember, knocked out. Who was that guy? I forget. Oh, Thiago Santos going for a reversal on the ground. So Eric Spicely can't do shit on the mat. If he is keeping his... Oh, beautiful transitions. Very nice by Eric Spicely. Got the back. Oh, no. Oh, no. Choke seems to be working. No, no, no. Body lock. Body lock. Oh, no, no, no. This is not looking good for Thiago Santos. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. This is bad. And Eric Spicely with the upset. Whoo! That is craziness. Eric Spicely cannot believe it. He's a shit himself. He's literally doing shitty motions. Of course, thank you, JD's hunting and fishing. I somehow feel this shows us what exactly you're trying to do with your channel. Tati Daddy obviously was a great name, but definitely feel the message is coming out loud and clear. Eric Spicely with the upset, my goodness. What the fuck just happened? Thiago Santos, you forgot your jits, man. What the hell? Eric Spicely knew what the hell he had to do and he went for it. He had no chance in the stand-up and he went for the ground game and just finished the fight. Both fights in today's fight night have ended with a rear naked choke. So that's what's happening. Who do you pick for the main? Come on, man. Come on. Is there any question who's gonna win the main event, people? Do you have any doubt? The four people who have somehow found this channel? Do not worry. This is not a dumb channel. We do this every fucking UFC fight. I pick Cris Cyborg. And if she loses, I'm ready to remove my t-shirt for you people. That is how confident I am in Cris Cyborg. I know you do not want to see me naked, but I also do not want to see me naked. That is why I'm very confident about it. Cyborg will demolish that bitch. I should not be disrespectful to women, but that's how it works around here in Brazil, man. That's how it works. JT, who do you pick in the main event? Is there anybody picking Lina Lansberg around here? Is there anybody alive on planet Earth who is still watching this particular event and still picking Lina Lansberg? I do not think so. There is a very small possibility, but still, it's Cyborg. Who are you kidding, man? Anyways, JT's hunting and fishing. Hopefully you've got your answer. Anyways, let me give you a quick update, people. This has been a pretty bad fight night till now. It has just suddenly woken up out of the slumber. And before I could even speak to one of my oldest subscribers, JT, two fights have got over. Just like that, we are rear naked chokes. The first fight of this boring prelim event was Gianco Franca versus Gregor Gillespie. Most of these fighters are unknown, man. first time UFC fighters are as such. It was pretty dominant performance for Gregor Gillespie. As you can see, the striking and the control was in favor. The only probable good spot in the prelims was Vincent Luque versus Hector Urbina. That was a fucking knockout, man. That was a crazy knockout victory for Vincent Luque. If you have not watched this, memes are getting made right now as we speak about this knockout. He was against the cage, Hector Urbina, and that punch fucking landed on the jaw and opened up his mouth. Meanwhile, Eric Spicely, who was on the last season's Ultimate Fighter, got his biggest victory of his career. So he is looking very happy. But then again, we got back to the boring fights. Alan Patrick against Stevie Ray. Again, one-sided fight. Striking was pretty even. But Alan Patrick got the takedowns going and got the smothering style to win that fight. That was also pretty one-sided and boring. Then we got one surprise in the middle of all of this shit. Eric Silva, as expected, defeating Luan Chagas. I do not know why Eric Silva is fighting so low in the prelims. But that fight was probably a good one because Luan Chagas got some knockdowns in there. It was a brawl fest pretty much, but again Eric Silva were coming out with the submission. Then we went to Jussier Formiga versus Dustin Ortiz. Striking wise, Dustin Ortiz was getting much better results, but Jussier Formiga got back his major trait, which is wrestling, and got it going in rounds 2 and 3. That is what happened between Jussier Formiga and Dustin Ortiz. Lansberg, there are people picking Lansberg. JT's hunting and fishing. What the hell? I may have to strip naked today, but I'm pretty confident JT is gonna lose. Anyways, getting back to the prelims, again Rani Yaya getting the victory against Michinori Tanaka. It was a very, very, very bad decision. Looking at the stats, obviously. Eric Spicely still walking out. At this rate, it will be tomorrow before he reaches the locker room and we get the next fight. So get the fuck out of here, Eric Spicely. We need to see the next fight. Then we had Gilbert Burns versus Michael Prezeres. This one actually was a surprise for me. Again, another takedown oriented fight. Michael Prezeres getting 5 takedowns overall and landing better striking throughout the fight. Finally, we moved into the main card. Can you imagine? Gilbert Burns was the highlight for the fight pass prelims of this fight night. Yeah, that's how bad it sucked. But anyways, some fights were interesting. So, moving on to the main card. By the time I could set everything up, this one was over. I should start setting these things up a little early, they told me. But anyways, Godfredo Pepe got the victory via rear naked choke. These guys were slinging some leather. That's what these people were doing. Knockdowns galore, but Godfredo Pepe's chin withstood. He got the back and he got a rear naked choke against Mike Della Torre, or Torre as they call him. Then we just had one more fight. Probably the upset of the evening till now, unless Lansberg can pull something off. Tiger Santos got taken down and choked out by Eric Spicely very early in round 1. As you can see, Thiago Santos forgot his ground game, forgot his takedown defense, and then pretty much it was one-sided. It's a good win for Eric Spicely though. Ultimate Fighter contestant, probably semi-finalist if I remember correctly. And then we move on to the next one, which is Francisco Trinaldo versus Paul Felder. If you're wondering why the fuck I'm talking like this, I have a very bad cold. Plus, since we are in Brazil, might as well talk a little bit Portuguese style English, right? I'm trying to do my best, okay? Okay. So, JT, if you're still listening to me, what's up with the hunting and fishing thing, bro? So, is that what you're going to be focusing on the channel, which you have? I'm sure that's what the name suggests, but what kind of hunting and fishing do you do, and what do you specialize in? Just tell our listeners so that they can check you out, man. So Cyborg's last four fights was against Leslie Smith, Ibrahimova, Van Duyn, and Charmaine Tweet. All of them have been first round knockouts. All of these. That is Chris Cyborg's record. Her overall record is, I think, 16 victories and 1 defeat. So Cyborg losing. See, we're all mortals. I believe in that. But Ronda Rousey's stand-up was weak. We all know. But Cyborg is more of a complete fighter compared to all of these females at 135 pounds. I seriously do believe UFC should create a 145-pound women's division and give the belt to Cyborg, man. If you looked at the weigh-ins, man, she was almost dry. No water left in that lady. Poor soul, man. Cyborg is a big woman. You guys understand that, right? So anyways, looks like JD's hunting is not listening. Anyways, so as I was saying, Cyborg is cutting close to 25 pounds to make the 140 pound limit. And finally, she's realized and told us that she cannot make this weight anymore. But still, UFC is trying to play this big brotherish type of role and trying to, you know, figure out what the fuck will Cyborg do eventually if she goes to 135. But she can't make 135, people. Cyborg can only make 140. That's the best she can do. And if you look at her at 140, man, she looks horrible. She cuts a lot of weight. She's a big girl. So, please, UFC. I know nobody listens to my shit anyways. But still, if you're listening, man, you need to create that 145-pound division for the women, man. Let Cyborg come into UFC. You fight at her weight. And if she wants to do super fights, let her do it, man. I think she deserves it by now. If you have given her a Fight Night main event slot, you know she's gonna sell, right? So do not treat her like this. Oh, all right, JD, all right, nice one. Any of you guys interested in archery and reviews relating to archery equipment, do subscribe to JD's Hunting and Fishing. Guy does a good job of it, I am sure, and he's been a long time subscriber of this channel. We're gonna support each other anyways. But I gotta tell you guys one good news. The good news is we just reached 100 subscribers, like last week. I did not, like just after the stream ended, Michael Johnson versus Dustin Poirier, we reached 100, and I really feel that's the first small step in the right direction. I know it's no big deal, but none of these 100 subscribers are family or people who I know from before. So all of these people are new people who have genuinely liked my channel and subscribed to it. So I really, really appreciate that gesture from all you people who are either watching or supporting me through subscriptions. So please do subscribe to the channel. This is MMA Live. I'm Harry. We break down all fights of UFC events. We do fight companions. We do results. We do live reactions. We pretty much do MMA all fucking time. So that's your channel for any live play-by-play and fight analysis broadcasts, which you can get. So I hear Joe Rogan is going to leave the commentary position, and I know that I do not do as good a job as him, not even close, but still, that is obviously the ultimate goal, to give you guys unbiased fight breakdowns as it happens live. So that is your channel, MMA Live. Thank you all for watching this today, because I mean it's everywhere in the world, but I agree, as an MMA fight fan, you gotta get up and do it. It's really early here at my location, and UFC Fight Night 95 Brazil has been going on pretty well, at least in the main card level. So that is your update on the channel and the fights till now. Thank you, JD. Oh, very nice, JD. Going on a mule deer hunt. Very nice. But, okay, don't judge me, people who are watching, but I'm a vegan. Plus, most people are vegan in my country. They don't eat that much meat. I do consume dairy and all the other stuff. I do eat eggs once in a while. So I'm not like pure vegan. But I was a pure vegan like till 2 years back, right from the time I was born. They told me it was a religious thing. So by the time I realized that this shit is fucked up, it was a little too late. But anyways, based on our religion, we are not supposed to kill some animals. But then don't worry, I have tried every possible meat which can be eaten. So I've tried everything, but it just doesn't suit my taste. So that's why I'm still staying away from the meat. Because for 20-25 years, if you don't eat meat and suddenly have to eat meat, it's a little difficult on the taste buds, right? Hope you guys understand. So vegans doing pretty good for me. Stay healthy. The only problem is the climate of my place. It's all kinds of fucked up. Sometimes it's 10 degrees or 5 degrees, sometimes it's 40 degrees Celsius. This place is fucked up anyways, but I love the place. I got a new house in here, so things are working out okay. Back to the fights. UFC 205 prelims have been announced. Luis Carmouche, Kirlin Sukagian, Rafael Natal, Tim Bosch, Jim Miller vs. Thiago Alves, Lamin Good vs. Bilal Muhammad, Tim Kennedy vs. Rashad Evans is gonna be on UFC 205 prelims. My goodness, UFC 205 is gonna be a banging card. That's gonna happen in New York, Madison Square Garden, people, in case you're wondering. Paul Felder versus Francisco Trinaldo is coming up. And Francisco Trinaldo is on a 6-fight win streak, if I'm not wrong. That is a lot of fights to win in the lightweight division, man. I was really surprised while I was checking out the profile of this guy. This guy's legit as fuck, so is Paul Felder. So that's the fight coming up next. Paul Felder versus Francisco Trinaldo, the Iron Dragon. Sorry for the mess behind me anyways, but yep. Do I move this side? Yeah, I gotta move this side. Paul Felder entering the octagon, I think for the first time in Brazil. Paul Felder is an underrated fighter from Philadelphia. Great stand-up work, lots of spinning shit, spinning techniques, and good Muay Thai. Reasonably good on the ground also, but slightly weak on the wrestling department as far as I've seen his fights and I remember. He's called as the Irish Dragon, if I'm correct. Entering the octagon is Paul Felder, coming up against the Brazilian Francisco Trinaldo. who's riding a 6-fight win streak. But Paul Felder is riding a 2-fight win streak. One of the only 3 fighters in UFC history to have a spinning back fist knockout, and has total 7 victories via knockout. Paul Felder is a good stand-up artist. Has a lot of potential, has entered the UFC just 2 years back, I think, and is doing reasonably good. Good up-and-coming fighter from Europe. So that is your next fight. Francisco Trinaldo entering the octagon, fighting out of Piauí, Amarante, Brazil. Massaranduba is his nickname, and Trinaldo brings the fight every time. You rarely see him back down from a fight. He will brawl with you, he will roll with you, he will do wrestling with you. He does it all. He is a well-rounded fighter, has got good power in his hands, but does not throw spinning shit like Paul Felder. But he's more of a traditional Muay Thai guy with solid Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. That is Francisco Trinaldo for you, and he is riding a 6-fight win streak. In case you're wondering where you can watch this, you can watch this on Sony ESPN, Hyper TV, SPO TV, Satana Sports, Fox Sports, TV3, Combat Sports, TV10, TSN2, TSN1 if you're in Canada, CTV2, CTV1 if you're in Canada, RDS, second longest active win streak for Francisco Trinaldo, 6 victories, 6 by knockout, 5 by submission overall, and 7 first round finishes. If you're in Africa, you can watch this on Fox Sports Africa. If you're in Costa Rica, you can watch this on UFC Network, any other South American country, UFC Network. And if you're in Brazil, you can watch this on Combate. That is your update for the channels you can watch this fight on without paying a single fucking rupee if you have cable. Trinaldo is coming to the fag end of his career. 38 years of age, 5 foot 9 inches and 17 inches reach. Paul Felder, on the other hand, has just reached or about to reach his prime. 32 years old, 5 feet 11 inches and also 70 and a half inch reach. Reach is identical, but height is a differential for Paul Felder. Oh, okay. So you'll be hunting then. Very nice. UFC 205 is shaping up to be a great event, ladies and gentlemen. The Irish Dragon, Paul Felder, getting introduced in the octagon. But he got booed. But Francisco Trinaldo is getting a really good evasion. 20 victories and 4 losses for Francisco Trinaldo. He fights out of Brasilia. And he is the favorite for today. Slight favorite, -135. If Paul Felder starts throwing some spinning shit, you're in for a fight, people. So better stay tuned into this. These ring girls are fucking amazing. My goodness, these South Americans and Colombians. Woo! It's getting hot in here. But anyways, back to the action. Paul Felder, Trinaldo, they touch gloves. Southpaw stands for Trinaldo and traditional stands for Paul. I thought Paul Felder also does southpaw once in a while. This one's going to be really interesting. And I feel can go to the decision, but it's going to be a really interesting matchup. So please stay tuned to MMA Live to hear the fight analysis and live breakdown of UFC Fight Night 95. Nice leg kick by Paul Felder, partially checked. These guys are feinting a lot, not committing. I think the right hand can be open to the body for Paul, but he is not risking getting hit to the head by Trinaldo by throwing the body punch. Nice leg kick by Paul Felder. Yes, JT, I did notice that. Nice tip kick to the body by Paul Felder. Oh, nice body kick by Trinaldo. That one landed hard. Oh, answered by Paul Felder. These guys are throwing with bad intentions. But still a lot of feints mixed in. This, oh, nice one too by Paul. Paul has a good chin though. Not sure about Trinaldo. Trinaldo is having a slightly weird stance today. I do not know why. Hits. Oh, nice. Oh, nice jab and body kick combination. Nice body kick by Trinaldo. Answered. Oh, nice spinning back fist by Paul Felder. This one's just getting started. Lots of feints. Straight misses for Paul Felder, the Irish Dragon. His hands are... Oh, nice combination by Paul, but answered by Trinaldo. Oh, nice left hook by Trinaldo. Paul Felder is getting lit up. Has to be careful. Oh, no. Nice left hook by Trinaldo. Oh, nice body kick by Trinaldo. My goodness, lighting Paul Felder up. They clinch up against the cage. Muay Thai plum for Trinaldo, but his height is at a disadvantageous position to pull the neck in. But still, he is going for it. They're still clinching. No over under. The plum is in. But Paul Felder defending reasonably. Oh, he's going for a trip, but is unsuccessful. Trinaldo's stance was looking weird, but his stand up is looking crisp. Favorite UFC fighter of all time? That's a tough question, JD. Who do I say? There are lots of them, but can't just pick one though. If you really have to ask me, I have a very controversial pick though. You gotta go with John Jones. If you're saying one, if you're focusing that, man, give me one. Gotta go with John Jones, man. I know he's done a lot of shit and all, but I don't know how many of you heard this, but he recently got confirmation that the pill he took was not a banned substance. It was more like a dick pill, which you take before fucking a prostitute or something. Paul Felder cannot be up against the cage. So looks like John Jones might be out pretty soon. Not in time for New York, though, I feel. But who knows, man? UFC's done weird shit. The single greatest fighter for me, probably John Jones. He's never been defeated. But, man, there's so many guys, man. Anderson used to be great back in the day. Still is, I feel. The only problem is age catches up with us all, doesn't it? Khabib is solid. Undefeated, 22-0. Khabib's been very, very underrated. Trash talk-wise, I mean, you can't forget about Conor McGregor. He's up there too. So is the legends like BJ Penn, man, the Prodigy, fighting next week. Or is it the week after that? Yeah, October 15th, the Prodigy is back. Nice one too by Trinaldo. Gotta say this. Oh, nice body kick by Trinaldo. These body kicks will hurt Felder eventually. 10 seconds remaining in the round. JT, you let me know who your favorite fighter is. And all the other guys, is there any favorite fighter of yours? Please let us know in the comment section. Cris Lieben. Yeah, Cris Lieben's good, man. None of his fights are not entertaining for sure. One of the greatest, probably UFC Hall of Famer material. But I'm looking at overall competition, the quality of the victories, them being as decisive as possible, plus overall a complete mixed martial artist. it's pretty difficult to argue against Jones, though, but he keeps getting into shit like this all the time. I feel like throwing the kitchen sink at him. If I see him, though, that's a different question, because he's gonna whoop my ass. By the time I pick up the kitchen sink, I'll probably be dead. So he had this hit and run, then he had this drug test incident. So who gives a fuck anyways? Let him come back. He'll probably win back the title against Cormier. That's a topic for another day. Meanwhile, we are ready for round two. Trinaldo's body kicks are getting through. Paul Felder has to defend these. Oh my goodness. Paul Felder will get knocked down pretty soon from a body kick. I feel his left side is fucking pink in color right now. Trinaldo looking crisp though. Paul Felder has to start throwing more, man. Let's leave it all in the octagon, as they say. Oh, beautiful leg kick by Paul Felder. The problem with Felder is his jabs are good. Oh, nice left hook by Trinaldo over the top. Oh, nice combination by Paul, body head. Paul Felder has to move, stick and move, son. Oh, beautiful combos by Francisco. Paul Felder has got a chin on him, ladies and gentlemen. Great chin, but he is losing the fight in my eyes. And since it's Brazil, you're not gonna get any favors from the judges. Paul has to start throwing more combinations. 2-3 punch combinations will work. He has to learn from his mistakes in round one. Cannot be up against the cage. Hello, legendary Brian in the house. Hello, legendary Brian. Welcome back to the channel. And guess what? We hit 100 subs, man. So thank you, legendary Brian, one of the oldest subscribers to the channel. Shout out to him. Trinaldo taking Paul Felder down. Oh my goodness, this is not looking good for Paul. Trip takedown by Trinaldo, landing up on guard. Decent defense by Paul. But this round is not looking good again. They are in the missionary position and fucking each other. No, I'm just kidding. They're not fucking each other. They're grown up men. So you say, can't men fuck each other, Harry? Yes, they can, but I'm not into that kind of shit anyway, so. No disrespect to the gay people, if someone's here. But they are actually... Oh, this is hardcore sex position, man. Stacking the guard and fucking him from behind. Sort of, in the asshole. But jokes apart, let's get back. Trinaldo's getting in some punches. Felder's guard is strong though. Oh, trying to pass. Nope. The guard is pretty open though. Felder has to close the guard and try to go for a arm triangle, maybe. That's possible. Looks possible. But Trinaldo's controlling the shoulders, so it might get difficult for him. He can push. He has to do the hip escape. Half guard. Oh, no. Elbow. Oh no, guillotine attempt. Guillotine by Trinaldo, but that's not gonna hold good. So Felder escapes. Trinaldo still grinding it on the ground. Still grinding it. Whoa, what the hell? Cyborg gonna beat some ass. Definitely. Congrats. Thank you, legendary Brian. We're gonna take it slow, baby. We're gonna get there. Oh, Paul Felder getting up, doing the cage walk. Beautiful. 50 seconds remaining in the round. Fight Night Brazil, UFC 95 on Fox Sports. In case you guys are wondering where you want to watch this, you can watch this on Sony 6, Sony ESPN, SPO TV, TSN TV, CDS. These are all channel names. Combate, if you're in South America. TV3, TV10, Fox Sports 1, Fox Sports 2. Oh, nice spinning back elbow by Paul Felder. Beautiful work. Done. So in case you're wondering how to watch these fights for free on cable, those are the major channels. Satana Sports. A lot of Chinese channels too showing these fights. 5 seconds remaining. 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're done. Paul Felder lost that round too. So it's pretty difficult for him to finish this fight. He's busted up. One of his eyes is bleeding due to a cut. Oh, that's not at a good position. That cut is near the inside of the eye. That might trouble his vision. Hopefully the referees don't stop the fight. He is bleeding profusely. How many of you feel that Cyborg is not gonna win? Let me know in the comment section, people. Because JT in here feels that Lina Lansberg can defeat Cyborg. I wish to disagree with him. Cris Cyborg demolishes bitches. I hope you remembered that. So anyone else who feels that Lina Lansberg has a shot of defeating Cyborg, please let me know in the comments. That's your main event coming up after two fights from here. Last round coming up. Paul Felder busted up but not out against Francisco Trinaldo, who is going for victory number 7. Trinaldo is going for the cruise to victory mode because he's trying to avoid any engagement here. That's what Trinaldo's doing. Paul Felder can land some bombs. Okay, nice knee. Paul Felder has to let go. Oh, head kick by Trinaldo. Paul Felder's chin is amazing. Trinaldo's running away from him. Paul Felder has to close the distance. Come on, Paul. Throw some shit, man. Come on. He's looking very tentative today. I do not know why. Oh, nice punch to the body. See, Trinaldo's just walking away from him. He's trying to create distance. Just trying to counter him if it's too close for comfort. Trinaldo knows that he won 2 rounds, so he can pretty much cruise in here. Paul Felder, I do not know what's happened. Is it due to an injury? He's not throwing as much as he used to. Oh, head kick misses for Paul Felder. Oh, nice straight by Trinaldo. Beautifully done. Goes out of range. Now he's enjoying himself. He's doing the Anderson Silva shit. Trying to feint and move away, feint, move away, and bang. Land one punch. Spinning back kick just misses to the head. Oh, nice left hook by Paul Felder. Paul has to throw some combinations in here. I do not know why he is not. Nice leg kick by Paul Felder. Cyborg, Patrick Benak, I pick Holly against Ronda. Okay. Okay, JD Hunting. I too picked Holly against Ronda. But today I'm not gonna pick Lina Lansberg for sure. Hopefully you've seen her previous fights. Lina Lansberg has got decent Muay Thai, but not at the level of Cris Cyborg. Nice left straight by Trinaldo. Paul Felder clinching up, reversal of position by Trinaldo. Nice knee to the body by Francisco Trinaldo. Going for win number 7. Not looking good for Paul Felder. He keeps this is looking pretty difficult. That cut has opened up again for Paul. He's not able to see clearly through the eyes. That blood is pouring straight into the eye. This might be a referee stoppage. That cut is not at a good location. They have waved away the fight. Sorry guys, but that fight just got pulled by the referee due to the blood on the Irish Dragon's head. But Francisco Trinaldo with victory number 7 consecutively. against top quality opposition. So Trinaldo going up very quickly, but Paul Felder still unable to string together more than two victories in his UFC career back to back. I don't like fights being stopped like this, but I think that cut was pretty brutal. All the blood was going into his eyes and he was anyways not seeing most of the punches coming in. Whew. So that concludes fight number 3 for UFC Fight Night 95 Brazil, Cyborg versus Lina Lansberg. Thank you guys for joining into the stream. This is MMA Live, your channel for all UFC fight analysis and live play-by-play. So in case you cannot watch these fights, I'm going to tell you which channels to watch this right now. Make a note of it. If you're in South America, you can watch this on UFC Network or Combate. If you're in Europe, you can watch this on Combat Sports, TV3, TV3 Sport 1, Viasat Sport, Viaplay, Match TV, NTV Plus, Viasat 4. If you're in North America, you can watch this on UFC on Fox, so Fox Sports 1. You can also watch this on Fox Deportes. If you're in Canada, you can watch this on CTV, TSN, or RDS. These are the channels which provide you these fights for free on cable. So if you have cable or XBMC, Kodi, any of these internet service providers who give you channels online, you can log in. If you're in Asia, you can watch this on Fox Sports 2, Sky Sports, Hang Mas, if you're in Cambodia. If you're in China, lots of good options for you. GDTV, PPTV, Best TV, BESTV. Philippines, Hyper TV is a very reliable channel. South Korea, SPO TV is also very reliable. Japan, you can watch this on Perform or Sony ESPN, Sony ESPN HD, Sony 6. These are the channels which are available in Asia. Meanwhile, Francisco Trinaldo getting the doctor stoppage victory against Francisco Trinaldo. A lot of mutual respect between these two gentlemen, but Francisco Trinaldo needs to have a top 10 opponent for his next fight, for sure. For sure. Anyways, the remaining channels where you can watch this is BT Sport. BT Sport, if you're in UK, that is one of the most reliable channels to watch these fights on. You can also watch this on Setanta Sports or Fox Sports Africa. These are all the channels which you can watch UFC fights on for free. No piracy, no shit, legal stuff. Probably the subscriptions are $1 or $2 per month. I think if you're an MMA fan, it's worth investing a couple of dollars on your favorite pastime, isn't it? Okay, so I'm gonna repeat the channels once again on request. You can watch these fights on Combat Sport. Okay, let me do one thing. I'll just put this up. Give me a second, guys. I made a spreadsheet for this. So let me just try to sync this up for you people. Sync this up for you guys. One second. This is just, for some reason it's not pulling up. Fuck this. So I'll probably figure out how to add this next time I do this, guys, but let me repeat the channels once more. Trinaldo meanwhile giving the post fight speeches in the octagon. Good victory for Francisco Trinaldo. good respect shown by the fighters. If you're in Europe, Middle East, or Africa, you can watch us on Fox Sports Africa, Setanta Sports, S-E-T-A-N-T-A Sports, BT Sport 2 or 3. That is probably the most reliable channel in the Europe to watch any UFC fight. TV3, TV10, Viasat Sport, and Viaplay. RAN Fighting, Combat Sport, Fox Sports, CTV, TSN, RDS. These are the channels in Canada. Then if you're in China, these channels will also work. GDTV, PPTV, BES, B-E-S TV. The channel which I am watching right now on is Sony ESPN HD. You can also watch this on Sony ESPN or Sony 6. Very reliable channels. I watch all my UFC fights on Sony ESPN. Shout out to those guys. Yes, you have to pay for this though, but not crazy amounts of money. I pay around $2 per month for watching Sony ESPN. It gives me football, gives me cricket, gives me the Olympics, gives me UFC, gives me pro wrestling, lots of variety on this channel. So you can get this channel either on cable or XBMC or Kodi. So that is the update. Yes, but that fighter, can you show it in the video? Cyborg is a man. That is true. That is partially true. She looks like a man. She's built like a man. But she's a woman. So next fight coming up is Roy Big Country Nelson with the big belly going up against Antonio Bigfoot Silva. Bigfoot Silva cuts down weight to reach 265 people. So that's going to be a good fight. Probably going to end soon because Antonio Silva's chin is deteriorating like shit all the time. Cyborg is a man. Go elbow queen. Cyborg's last loss was a Muay Thai fight. JD, you are correct. But if you remember, the woman she was going up against was a multiple time decorated Muay Thai fighter. And it was not an MMA fight, remember? It was a kickboxing fight. Or was it MMA? I forget. But it looks like, from my memory, it's more of a stand-up oriented fight. And Cyborg lost that one. But that was way back in the day, man. That was way back in the day. It's possible, but I really feel Cyborg will come out victorious for sure on this fight. Anyways, it's me against you. I've already told you guys, if Cyborg loses, I'm gonna take my shirt off. That's the bet I have with JT. Hunting and fishing. So that's what's gonna happen today. Coloca a luta. That means where the fuck is the fight, I believe. Oh, that is Wade Bio Bloodgood. Wade Bloodgood. Thank you for the concern. That is only because the mic is too close to my nose. See, so if I breathe like this. Yeah, I do have cold today. I gotta agree, Wade. But yeah, it's been pretty bad today. So I have got it checked up. I'm on medication. They say it's gonna be okay, so should not be a problem. But thank you really very much for the concern. That is actually the first time somebody's asked about this. So thank you, Wade Bloodgood, for the concern. And I have a lot of cold today, and it's around 6-7 degrees. No, not 7 degrees. Around 10 degrees Celsius at my location. So it's really cold. The room is warm enough. I've got a heater running and all that, but the temperature differential is pretty bad. So let me keep the mic a little away so that you don't hear the breaths that much for today. Anyways, so Bigfoot gonna lose, definitely, I feel. But hey, Bigfoot can still land a punch anytime. So it's difficult to underestimate Bigfoot. But, you know, Roy Nelson's chin is legendary. It's the stuff of legends. Roy Nelson can take a beating like no one. Like, I do not know how Roy Nelson walks around after taking so much damage from Stipe Miocic, from Alistair Overeem. You name it, that guy has taken some punishment. The only guy ever to finish Roy Nelson is Mark Hunt, who finished him with a walk-off KO, like his trademark uppercut. But apart from that, man, Roy Nelson's chin has held up. The time is not right for him to get knocked out, but you never know. This is the heavyweight division, and Bigfoot Silva, I don't know whether he's training or not, but looks like he's going to retire very, very soon. He's taking these fights fast after getting knocked out, which is not really advisable. Hopefully, Wade, you can't hear my breathing now that much, because the mic is fucking awesome, though. It picks up my intestines noises also most of the time. See, if I keep it near my intestine, I'm just kidding. But anyways, it's a pretty decent mic. In case you're wondering what this mic's make is, this is the BM800 with a shock mount, with a usual cable. What do you call this? XLB or something like that, which goes into 3.5mm jack on my laptop, and that is where I broadcast it from. Salaamu Alaikum, Sheikh Amin. Hopefully you're doing well. Walaikum Assalam. I think that's what you reply with. Hopefully you're doing well, Sheikh Amin. Wade Bloodgood, 100%. Okay, thank you. Who's fighting now? The next fight is Roy Nelson versus Antonio Bigfoot Silva, and we're left with two other fights. Renan Barao versus Philip Noor for the co-main, and then we got the big one, Cris Cyborg Justino versus Lina Elbow Queen Lansberg. Lina Lansberg looks real good, though, like as a person, as a chick. Like, you can take her out on a date and stuff. But that's not going to solve the problem here, because she's going up against Cris Cyborg. The co-main is a very interesting fight. A lot of people do not know who Philip Nover is. He's a very, very good stand-up and Brazilian jiu-jitsu fighter. His ground game is pretty decent. And Renan Barao is on a downward skid right from the time he lost the title to TJ Dillashaw. But anyways, the next fight is Roy Nelson vs Antonio Silva. As usual, if you want to watch any of these fights, I just told with the channels where you can watch these fights on. I'll probably put a banner or maybe take a picture and post it from my next stream onwards. There are lots of channels who give you these fights for free. I don't do this illegally. I do this legally. I pay around $2-3 a month to watch these fights and other sports on these channels. So it works out pretty well. So in case you guys are wondering, on my next stream, you will get a detailed breakup of where you can watch all UFC fights, irrespective of whether it's a pay-per-view or a fight night show. Till then, keep it logged in. This is your channel, MMA Live. We break down all UFC fights live for you guys and do a breakdown. That is what we do on this channel. The heavyweights are coming
not literally, they're coming into the octagon. And Roy Nelson's got a lot of good victories against top quality competition. He's famous for his overhand right. His knockout of Czech Congo is the stuff of nightmares. But Bigfoot Silva is fading. He's at the tail end of his career. So is Roy Nelson. It's possible. But till then, we got a good fight ahead of us. In the lungs. Okay.
Vai tomar no cu, viado, pau no su. What was I about to say? Fucked up, man. Anyway, it's too early.
It's too fucking early. Bigfoot Silva entering the octagon. That was what I was about to say. He's grown his beard thinking that he will not get knocked out.
That beard is going to protect him. But hey, man, that it doesn't work like that. They will find your chin and they will dismantle you. But Roy Nelson is working on the ground game these days. So you never know, this might go to the ground anytime. But jiu-jitsu wise, I would have to give the advantage to Antonio Silva. And for the very first time in a Fight Night broadcast, we have got a lot of people watching it simultaneously with me. Really excited. Good to have you guys with me today. This fight is happening in Brazil. This is UFC Fight Night 95, I believe. So number 100 coming up for them too. Shout out to all the subscribers who have tuned in. Special thanks to all of you. You are the guys who make this channel work like no other. Bigfoot Silva has straightened his hair for some reason. He's growing his hair. But these two gentlemen are really, really old. Wade Bloodgood seems to have a good sense of humor. Fuck USA, okay. Why do we have to do this, Sheikh Amin? Why? Let us not hate on countries, man. These are all people, right? Let's show some love. Bigfoot Silva has finished 17 of his 19 victories. 15 by knockout, 4 by submission. He has victories over Alistair Overeem. He has victories over Travis Brown. So do not underestimate Silva, but he's getting old. So if you're a Silva and you're getting old, you should probably not fight. So the pun was for Anderson, but this guy's Antonio. He's in the heavyweight division. Anderson is older than Bigfoot, though. Anderson's 41. And I believe his contract is coming to a close. Antonio Silva is jogging in the octagon. It is looking really weird. But big country is in the house, fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Number 11 ranked Roy Nelson. His nickname is Big Country. What time is it here? It is, it's around, now it's almost what? Let me see. Yeah, it's around 8-ish, 8 a.m. It's pretty early here. So yeah, weird timelines for this fight, but still very excited to see all the MMA fans watching this. Roy Nelson is a former IFL heavyweight champion, fifth most knockouts in UFC heavyweight history, and has finished 18 of his 22 victories, 14 by knockout, 4 by stoppage or submission. That is Roy Nelson. He weighed in at 258 pounds. Antonio Silva weighed in at 265. Bigfoot Silva used to be a lot more leaner and meaner, but off late he has been putting on some weight. Henan Barao's fight has not come yet. Mr. Cody. Zayden Cody. In case you're wondering where the fuck is the fight, we are not a channel which shows you fights. We are a channel, we break down fights.
So we do live play-by-play. As you can see in the description of the video, I've clearly mentioned this is a play-by-play and fight analysis. But as I've told you already, I've mentioned all the channels where you can watch these fights live with me. And I'll put it up on the stream next week or the week after once we are done with UFC 204. The breakdown: Roy Nelson is 6 feet, Bigfoot is 6 feet 4. Nelson weighed in 248, 72 inches reach. Bigfoot weighed in 265, 80 inches reach. Roy Nelson is 40 years old and Bigfoot is 37 years old. So Bigfoot still has got some time left in his gas tank. Okay, people, let's stop the comments on countries at least. Let's focus on the fights here, right, Sheikh Amin? That's what we're here to do. 6 feet four. This guy is as tall as his coach who's climbing on the back of the cage. That is how tall Bigfoot Silva is. This fight is happening in Brazil, so Bigfoot Silva's got a lot of support. A lot of support for Bigfoot. Roy Nelson, 22 victories and 13 losses. Bigfoot Silva, 19 victories and 9 losses in his career. The favorite, as per Las Vegas odds, minus 450, is Roy Nelson. Big country. No. Renan Barao's fight. Zayden Cody, you gotta listen to me. Renan Barao is still yet to fight. The ring girls are amazing in Brazil. I love all of them. Luciana Andrade, Jenny Andrade, and one more girl. I even remember the ring girls' names, man. What the hell? This is some real shit. Round one. They touch gloves. A lot of respect. Oh no, Bigfoot stance is very weird. No, this is not good looking for Bigfoot. He's open for the overhead. Oh, nice body kick to the body by Bigfoot Silva. Nelson will go for the overhead straight away. Bigfoot has to be careful. No. Throwing with the jab. Going in with the jab, Roy Nelson. Oh, nice straight punch by Bigfoot. Nice counter. But Roy Nelson's chin is legendary. Overhand right by Bigfoot Silva. Bigfoot Silva going for the kill. But remember, don't leave your chin open, son. Oh, nice leg kick by Bigfoot. Beautiful. Oh, nice punches by... Oh, these guys are throwing bombs. Bigfoot Silva... Can he get a victory after a long time? Roy Nelson has to be careful here. Oh, he went for the overhead but got kneed in the body. Bigfoot Silva doing really well till now. Throwing some feints, Roy Nelson. Oh, nice kick to the body, grazes Roy Nelson. Oh, overhand right. This is going to connect eventually if Roy Nelson keeps going for it. He has to move out of the cage. Bigfoot has to move out of the cage. Circle to the left, son. Yes. That is better. They take the center. One punch is all it takes. This is the heavyweights. So Roy Nelson is not going to the ground today. Looks like it. Oh, nice punch by Nelson. That wobbled Bigfoot a little bit. Oh, that punch didn't work. Nice kick to the body by Antonio Silva. Oh, nice hook lands for Nelson again. If it's a chin battle, Roy Nelson's gonna win this. Bigfoot Silva looks real slow. Real slow. No, not against the cage, son. Nice straight right by Bigfoot. 2 minutes remaining.
Oh, nice right hook. Two right hooks landed for Nelson. Silva's hurt. Looks like it. Nice kick to the body. Oh, nice spinning back fist partially landed for Nelson. Oh, nice 1-2 by Antonio. Nice punches. Good brawl. Good brawl going on. Okay, Sheikh Amin, let's not talk about all of this, man. Come on. I'll have to remove you eventually. Let's not talk about countries here, please. This is the last time I'm telling you, man. Let's not stop the fight flow. Let's keep it going on the fights, okay, Sheikh? I don't care if you hate USA. I don't give a fuck. Nobody here does. If you hate USA, fine. We respect it. But we don't, okay? And I'm not from USA. So let's just let it go. Let's just focus on the fights, right? Anyways, clinch work against the cage. Roy Nelson pressing the cage against the face of Bigfoot. The beard is holding good for Bigfoot Silva. Thank you, Andrew Hinsey joining in. Legendary Brian joining in. JT joining in. Thank you, guys. Hennen never fought yet. Yes, Hennen Barao did not fight yet. That is the next fight after this one. 20 seconds remaining in the fight. This is really difficult to score, man. Nice knee to the body by Bigfoot. That got a grunt from Nelson. Nelson got to get a takedown. Oh! Nice punch by Bigfoot. Bigfoot says, bring it. 5 seconds. Four. Oh, the round ends. Good round, man. But really difficult to judge who got the better of the exchanges. Nelson got some control in, but I think Bigfoot landed slightly better. Slightly. But pretty difficult to score the round anyways. Very, very slow fighters. Andrew Hinsey, I just made a spreadsheet, though I repeated it to everyone. So in case you want to watch this fight quickly, I'm going to go through this one more time, people. Make a note. I'm watching this on Sony ESPN. This is also available on Sony 6, SONYSIX. Other channels are going to be as follows. Hyper TV, SPOTV, BT Sport, Fox Sports 1 and 2, Combate, Setanta Sport, GDTV, PPTV, and BESTV. These are the top channels for you guys to watch the fights with me. So get into Cody or XBMC or any internet service provider. Nice leg kick by Bigfoot Silva. Round 2 begins with a bang. Nice teep kick by Bigfoot. Nice body kick. Okay. Lot of, what do you say? Showing what they're throwing, man. Gas tank wise, I have to say Nelson still holds the advantage the later this goes. Oh, overhead slightly grazes him. Oh, just misses the high kick, Bigfoot Silva. Bigfoot actually looking not bad today. Changing of stances. I do not know why Bigfoot is having a southpaw stance. He fights orthodox. Oh, nice right hook by Bigfoot Silva. Nice kick to the body, partially blocked by Nelson. Nice leg kick again. These leg kicks are working for Bigfoot. Can Bigfoot pull out the victory though? It's possible. Did Roy Nelson undertrain for this? Oh man, Roy Nelson is swinging for the fences, but nothing is landing. Nice deep again by Bigfoot Silva. Oh my goodness. Brawl time. Nice jab by Nelson. Oh, nice overhead by Nelson. That wobbled him. Nelson has to go for it right now. Push the button, son. Roy Nelson has to throw in some combinations. Oh, God. Shit. Groin kick by Bigfoot, man. I hate when these fighters do this. I know it's not intentional, but if a heavyweight hits you in the nuts, man, those nuts are gonna go. That is hard. Shit. But Roy Nelson's like, yeah, you know what? Not a big deal at all. Roy Nelson just shrugs it off. A 265-pound man just kicked him in the nuts with full force. And Roy Nelson says, bring it. That is how gangster Roy Nelson is. Yeah, Silva. Oh. Combinations by Silva. What the hell is happening? Silva going for a takedown, but not getting it at all. Even Roy Nelson smiled, man. That is not what Bigfoot wants to do, man. He's not good at wrestling. He has to go back to the stand-up. He's grabbing his ass, basically. Oh, okay. They split up. 2 minute 35, 34, 33, if you want to sync it up with me. But definitely these guys are tiring. Nice left hook, nice uppercut. Okay. But didn't land cleanly though. By Nelson. Bigfoot is playing so. Oh, nice punch lands for Nelson. Yes, that one landed clean. He has to throw some combination. Lead with the jab, Mr. Nelson. You got to lead with the jab. Throw a 1-2. Or maybe 3-5 or 3-4. Something. Okay. Bigfoot going for the takedown but does not get it. Nelson defending well. Looks like Nelson is slowly getting the round back. Oh, nice uppercut. Nice uppercut by Nelson. Oh, nice straight punch by Nelson. Oh, shit. Those two punches landed clean. Bigfoot Silva still hanging in there. Whew, this is some close shit to score, man. I pity the judges. Pretty difficult to score. First round, neck and neck, but probably edged by Silva. This round, really close. Oh, nice overhand lands for Lansel again. What happened to the power of Nelson, man? Oh, nice body kick. It's really funny to watch Roy Nelson getting kicked in the body. Oh, uppercut lands for Roy Nelson. My goodness. He drops him. It is all over. Roy Nelson defeats Bigfoot Silva. Woo! Whoa, what the hell happened? What's happening? Oh. Okay, now I understood what's happening. So Roy Nelson basically was angry against Big John McCarthy. Not against Bigfoot. So he was out though. Bigfoot was out. But Big John McCarthy took a long time. That uppercut landed clean as everyone was saying in the comments. Those punches shouldn't have followed. Oh, that uppercut was clean, man. 1, 2, 3. He's out. He's out already. 4, 5. He's out, man. Yeah, finally, John McCarthy steps in. So it wasn't against John McCarthy. Good fight, though. Good fight, people. Good fight. Bigfoot should retire, yes. Probably. So that was a clean uppercut followed by some 6 punches on the ground. I think John McCarthy could have stepped in a little early. I understand Nelson's frustration.
and he expressed it by kicking John McCarthy away. That's what he did. He shouldn't have done it though. He's a referee. But I understand why Roy Nelson kicked John McCarthy. But they showed some respect to each other. And as usual, they had to be separated eventually. But they hugged afterwards, so that's no problem there. Roy Nelson finishing his fight with a beautiful uppercut and ground and pound. Bigfoot Silva loses one more time. That is really sad. That is really, really sad to see. Now Hennen is fighting. Correct, Mr. Art Dreamer. So we are left with two fights. The co-main between Philip Noor versus Hennen Barao. And the main event featuring Lina Lansberg and Cris Cyborg. Till the official decision comes in, I'm going to tell you guys one more time where to watch all of these fights on. I should just put a picture, I understand, but I have it on a spreadsheet today and for some reason it is not showing up for you guys. Anyways, these are channels quickly: Combat Sports, TV3, Viasat, RAN Fighting, NTV Plus, Match TV, TV3, TV10, Sony ESPN, Sony 6, Hyper TV, SPO TV, BT Sport 2, CTV, TSN, RDS, Fox Sports in USA, Fox Sports Africa, GGTV, GDTV, PPTV, and Best TV. Roy Nelson doing the post-fight interviews. Those are the channels, people, where you can watch these fights live. Most of those channels will cover it live for you. Let me hear the interview because... Okay, so Roy Nelson keeping it classy in the post-fight knockout. I agree with him that the fight should have been stopped a little earlier. Let me know what do you think if you're watching this fight. There were 2-3 punches which were really hard which landed on Bigfoot. And, you know, Bigfoot is getting really old. And his chin is not up to mark, so, yep. Our Dream Alina by third round KO. Are you serious? It's time for Cris to lose. Yeah, probably. It looks like a lot of rejects in tonight's card, but it's been a pretty good card till now. The first two fights were really, really good. Let me show you what happened there. The first fight was Gottfriedo Pepe versus Mike De La Torre. A beautiful stand-up war. De La Torre got lit up on the feet, wobbled multiple times, and Gottfriedo Pepe took his back and choked him out with a beautiful rear naked choke. The defense of Mike De La Torre was very poor in the first fight of the main card. Then we had probably the shocker of the night till now. Thiago Santos getting choked out by Eric Spicely. Eric Spicely took him down, took his back, and Thiago Santos is known for his stand-up, but his ground game was very weak today. Then the third fight was also a stoppage, but due to the doctor, because Francisco Trinaldo cut up Paul Felder near the eye, and the doctor had to step in. But anyways, Trinaldo was winning the fight overall. Then we had the current fight, which just ended. Thomas Almeida in the house, who got knocked out by Cody Garbrandt.
So Roy Nelson defeating Antonio Silva via knockout, via a beautiful uppercut and followed up with some punches on the ground. Two more fights remaining: Renan Barao versus Philip Noor, and Cris Cyborg versus Lina Lansberg. A lot of people are tuning in to watch this Fight Night card, which is really encouraging for the channel and for the MMA community in general. Nobody can take that left hand shot ABCD with the comment. So let me know, guys, what about the co-main, man? Let's talk about the co-main. Who you got in the co-main event? I gotta say Barao might edge it out in decision. It's possible. Okay, ABCD. Okay. You think I'm gonna sit here and let you trash talk? Okay, ABCD. ABCD, figure shit out. I'm waiting for you if you want some comments like that. Art Dreamer, okay, some friendly banter going on in the comment section. Guys, what do you think about the co-main, man? There's still a fight to come. Let's not get all excited already. Cyborg is still around 10 minutes away from fighting, 10-15 minutes for sure. So till then, let's talk about the co-main. Renan Barao versus Philip Noor. It's gonna be a close fight. A lot of people don't know Philip Noor, but legit stand up and ground game for Philip. A lot of submissions and knockouts mixed in, but Renan Barao was at one point pound for pound one of the best. Till then, you got the UFC top five middleweights. Michael Bisping is a champ, Luke Rockhold number one, Chris Weidman number two, Jacare number three, and Yoel Romero number four. Number one is fighting number three, Rockhold versus Jacare in Melbourne. Weidman versus Romero probably for UFC 205. But surprisingly, the champion is Michael Bisping. And when he knocked out Luke Rockhold with that left hand punch, that was one of the biggest surprises of the year. Who hates Khabib? I don't hate Khabib, man. Khabib's fine. I actually feel Khabib deserves the title shot, but I mean, who wants to watch Khabib fight? That's also a reality. People want to watch Conor fight Eddie. So they're still figuring out the main event for 205. The press conference for UFC 205 is, I think, tomorrow, if I'm not wrong. So if they don't figure out UFC 205, probably the main event will be Eddie Alvarez versus Khabib Nurmagomedov, or they might change it up to Tyron Woodley versus Wonderboy. Wonderboy Thompson. I'll give you an update on that quickly. 205, the fights which have been confirmed as of now are Tyron Woodley versus Wonderboy Thompson. That's confirmed. Misha Tate will fight Raquel Pennington. That's also confirmed. And probably the biggest fight, according to me, is Joanna Jędrzejczyk fighting Karolina Kowalkiewicz. So JJ versus KK is going to happen in UFC 205. Tim Kennedy going up against Rashad Evans in the prelims. Can you believe that? The prelims is featuring Rashad Evans and Tim Kennedy. Meanwhile, they're showing the promo for UFC 204. Vitor versus Gegard. Gegard should get it. Vitor's not the old Vitor, man. It has to be TRT Tor. Khabib fight hairdressers. Khabib fights people in the 30 rankings. Okay, that's also possible. That is correct, though. Dota, what a fuck every day. All right. I also play Dota, man. That's a nice game. Okay, till the next fight comes, I'm just going to drink some water and come back. Co-main. Let's do the predictions here. McGregor can win first round knockout. It is possible. But hey, Eddie Alvarez has a great chin, stupendous wrestling, and also has some serious power in his hands. And if I have to agree with Art Dreamer, yeah, nobody can take that left hand shot. I agree. But if there is somebody who can take it, it's probably Eddie Alvarez. Nate Diaz took it pretty well. So Eddie Alvarez is known for his chin and grinding style. But can Conor win? Definitely. There's a good possibility there for Conor to do the victory. Dominic Cruz doing the fights for the first time in a long time, full time. So Dominic Cruz is in a full-time analyst position for today's UFC Fight Night in Brazil, number 95. And he's doing a really, really good job of it. He has a good brain, good talks, good analysis overall. So shout out to Dominic, the Dominator Cruz, in my opinion, one of the greatest fighters of all time. Twisted Alliances. Let us hear the fights. All right. I don't know whether my mic can pick it up. I'm pretty much on high volume here. My TV is a little on that side. It's pretty far away, so... yeah. Sheikh Amin is still here. Okay, Sheikh Amin. I guess it's time. Son Goku. Okay, what? Okay, Allahu Akbar, fine, but why jihad, man? Why fuck USA and all that? So, Sheikh Amin, I'm going to remove you now. All right? It's high time. Okay, Son Goku, let's not get into any of that bullshit here. I appreciate you honoring your God and your prophet. No problems with that. But let's keep the fights going. Let's keep the talk going only on the fights. Let's not hate between countries, religions, and customs. That's not what we do here. So Sheikh Amin, I didn't want to do it. Told you already, but too many fuck USA and all the other chants. Not correct, man. So gotta block you. Anyways. Son Goku is laughing out loud for some reason. Alright. Okay. Okay, so they're showing the promo for Flip Nover versus Renan Barao. Renan Barao used to be the greatest pound for pound fighter at one time. His submissions are crazy. Stand up is also looking good. But he was so tired cutting weight to 135 that eventually he had to move up. Philip Nover has got good ground games and submissions. Good wrestling and submissions by Philip Noor. Okay, chill, people, chill.
Guys, we're not here to talk about religion. This... Era, motherfuckers. ABCD is a Conor McGregor fan. Albuquerque in the house. Okay. Can't wait for UFC 205 for sure. Me too. Next fight coming up is the co-main event of the evening between Philip Noor versus Renan Barao. First to the octagon is Philip Noor fighting out of Brooklyn, New York. Yeah? Okay. Looks like a Filipino to me. Oh wait, he is from Philippines, but he fights out of Brooklyn, New York. All right. So that is Philip Noor for you. He took a long break due to injuries and had to figure out some other stuff before he steps back into the octagon. I think this is his first fight after recovering from his previous injuries, and it's a pretty bad fight for him because Renan Barao is still dangerous. Plus, he doesn't have to cut a lot of weight. But Renan Barao did get defeated by Jeremy Stephens in his last fight. So I'm not sure whether Renan is really back or not. Okay, Ray the Axe Murderer Malone. Ray, let's keep it down, right, son? Let's keep it down. Let's not hate on any particular religion here. I don't know why you people are so angry today. I'm really surprised. I'm surprised, motherfuckers. I really am. Here comes Renan Barao. Everybody sports yellow in Brazil. He fights out of Natal, Rio Grande do Norte. His Twitter handle is Renan Barao UFC. Looks like the old Barao for me. Looks like he's enjoying himself. He's dancing to the octagon. Hopefully he doesn't get taken down and submitted by Philip Noor, because he's on a two-fight losing streak. He lost his title shot against TJ Dillashaw, and he lost his 145-pound debut against Jeremy Stephens. Jeremy Stephens, one of the hardest hitters in 145 pounds. Eddie's a white belt on the mat or on the mat? Ray, you don't have to leave. I did not mean that, okay? Just let's get the hate down, okay? Let's not get religions mixed up here. That's all I said. All right, guys. Let's focus, man. This is co-main. What the fuck am I doing? Okay. That is my Daniel Cormier impersonation. Renan Barao is ready. They're pouring water on the mat for some reason. Is that allowed? So much water. And they're pouring some water in his mouth. Renan Barao drinking the same water which was poured on the mat. Not from the mat, but pretty much the same water. Let's hear the tale of the tape. I think Barao could be the younger fighter here. I just have a feeling. Yes, I'm correct. Philip Noor is 32, but is very tall. 5 feet 9 inches. For featherweight, that's pretty tall. He's born in USA. Okay. Barao's 29, 5'6". Barao has a 70-inch reach, and Philip Noor has a 72-inch reach overall. Travis Brown versus McGregor. See, ABCD keeps the comments rolling in favor of Conor for some reason. Anyways, the underdog plus 350 is Philip Noor. Philip Noor. Renan Barao's nickname is... I forgot. Anyways, Renan Barao is the favorite, minus 500. 35 victories, 4 losses.
That is Henan Barao's record. 1 second, guys. Okay, we're ready for the co-main. It's about to begin. The referee is Big John McCarthy again. Hopefully he does not stop the fight prematurely or lately. Who the hell is this ring girl, man? She is fucking hot. Okay. Hi. And I'm not saying hi to everybody. I'm saying the name of the person who just posted a comment on Lina Lansberg. Yeah, I guess most of us want to do that, but that is also not appropriate. Nice leg kick by Barao. So Barao's moving well today. Nice bounce, nice jab by Barao. The spinning back kick to the body of Barao is very dangerous, so Philip Nora has to be aware of it. And the jiu-jitsu work of Barao is also very, very dangerous. Both guys throwing in a lot of feints. Oh, nice leg kick, but answered by Philip Nora over the top. Right hand for Philip Nora. These guys need to start throwing something and stop fainting. Oh, nice, nice left hook. Barao has to be careful. Okay, nice punch to the body by Barao. Barao's chin is not his old self, that is for sure. Nice straight right missed by Barao slightly. The crowd is getting crazy here. Oh, nice jab by Philip Noor. Oh, nice 1-2-3 combination. Not 1-2-3. 1-2-1 combination by Henan Barao. That rocked Philip Noor. Philip Noor has to be careful with the stand-up, though. He should not rush in. Keep the chin tucked in nicely. Yes. Oh! Okay. Philip Noor is confident in his stand-up. He dropped Barao partially. Maybe it was a slip. Not sure. Oh, nice leg kick by Barao. Nice body kick answered by Philip Noor. A lot of Brazilian fans in the house. Oh, nice left hook straight combination by Henan Barao. Nice jab by Philip. Barao has to stop kicking the legs and focus on the top because he's getting hit whenever he goes for the legs. Philip Noor throwing with bad intentions. Barao looks too relaxed for some reason. He's just bouncing all over the place. Oh, nice left jab by Philip. He's timing him. Oh, he did the Fabricio walking around and punching thing, but did not get caught. Nice leg kick again by Barao. Beautiful leg kick. This fight might go the distance, looking like it, because it's the featherweight division. And the only person who can finish fights in the featherweight division consistently is the featherweight champion, Conor McGregor. No, leg kicks exchanged by both men. Left punches exchanged by both men. Philip Noor looking patiently for an opening. His left jab is finding a home. So is the right leg kick of Barao. Yeah, nice leg kick again by Barao. Oh, nice uppercut and right hook by Barao. That was a good combination. Nice timing. Barao finding his rhythm slowly. Slowly stopping the bouncing. The spinning back kick looks open for Barao, but he's not trying it for some reason. The Yuva Mohe chants are starting in Brazil. X video win. What the hell? 30 seconds remaining in round one. Nice leg kicks again by Barao. The leg kicks are finding a home. Close first round. Oh, he went for a spinning hook kick, but did not connect. Nice left hook by Hennen. He has to move the head off the center when he's throwing these punches. That's, oh, a nice kick to the body by Philip Noor. Last 10 seconds. Nope. We do not get a knockdown. So that is round one in the books. Philip Noor wants to get the crowds excited, but they're not going to chant in favor of him. I guess Enan Barak got that round. Slightly. Very slightly. But anyways, till the next round begins, you know the channel. The channel name is MMA Live. I'm Harry. And do like the video and subscribe if you love the Fight Companion stream, which we do every week for all the MMA fight fans, the true fight fans, who tune in to watch every fight, irrespective of the location, irrespective of the time, just like me. Appreciate all of you guys joining in today. This is the highest amount of concurrent subscribers and users I've got on my channel for any fight night event. And I am sure if this is the pull we have for Cyborg, the UFC should create a featherweight division just for Cris Cyborg, so that she does not cut so much weight. Round two begins in similar fashion. Both the fighters taking the center. Leg kick is still available. I'm surprised Philip Noor is not going for the takedown. I'm really surprised, because that is where his forte is. Oh, nice overhand right by Hennen. Both punches connected, left and right. But Philip Noor taking it. Both guys exchange jabs. Nice leg kick by Barao again. Feeling the rhythm is Hennen Barao. Nice leg kick again by Hennen Barao. Beautiful. Oh, spinning hook kick to the face connects. Philip Noor says, bring it. Yuva Mohe means you will die. That is what it means, legendary Brian. So that is what the Brazilian fans are chanting. Oh, nice left hook by Hennen. Beautiful connection. Nice leg kick followed up. Hennen's looking good. Hennen is looking good. Oh, nice left punch. Oh, nice jumping knee by Hennen. Jumping double knee catches Philip Noor in the face. Hennen Barao is feeling it. Can we get a finish in round two? Nice leg kick by Hennen Barao. This is the old Hennen Barao we are talking about, people. The one who demolishes people. The one who can stand and bang with the best. Finally, Hennen Barao is looking good in the octagon against a UFC caliber fighter. It's been a long time coming, but it's finally here. Hennen Barao doing good. One more leg kick landed by Hennen. Philip Noor has to take the fight to the ground, has to score a takedown, otherwise he's not winning this fight. Clearly, as you can see, the number of punches thrown by Barao is significantly higher. Nice left jab by Philip Noor. Good connection, but overall, Barao is just outlanding him. Nice punch to the body by Hennen Barao. Nice leg kick again by Hennen Barao. He's trying for that spinning hook kick technique, but he's not catching him. Nice left jab answered with a kick by Philip.
1 minute 45 seconds remaining in the round. Oh, nice punches by Barao again. Good job overall. Never mind, found it. Okay. Round two looking good for Hannon. Oh, nice left hook again by Hannon. Philip Norris got a good chin though. He's doing pretty well in handling these punches by Barao. A lot of feints by both guys. Not a lot of action. Oh, nice left hook again. This left hook is connecting for Hannon over and over again. Deep kick attempt to the face, but does not connect. Grazes him. We only have the main event remaining after this. Round two coming to a close. 15 seconds remaining. Hannon Barao going for a takedown and gets it. Beautifully done by Hannon. Goes for a trip takedown and lands it flush. Stepping into guard. Going for some punches. And the round ends clearly. A good round for Hannon Barao. So that is 2-0 in my books. In favor of Hannon Barao. BIRL. What does that mean? Art Dreamer. Okay. Why are we talking about asses suddenly in the comments? Is it because of high or ABCD? Yeah, it's because of high. Art Dreamer, are you male or female? Round three coming up. Beautiful Jenny Andrade. Really feel that the Brazilian ring girls do the best work ever overall, and they are one of the most exotic looking females on the planet. And why are we talking about tight ass then? Maybe you work out and stuff, I guess. I can't understand that. Round three, we're ready. Philip Nora has to go for a finish, otherwise he's not winning this fight. Oh, nice 1-2 by Hannon. Nice connection. Oh, no, you cannot do that Fabricio Verdum dance. Don't do the chicken dance, man. Hannon Barao has to keep it cool. Don't rush in with the punches. Nice leg kick by Hannon. Yeah, this is better. Not a lot of... Oh, nice right hook by Hannon Barao. Lands clean. Deep kick answered by Philip Noor. Yeah, I did. You caught me. You caught me. I did not want to laugh at Lina Lansberg comment. Oh, beautiful tripping by Hannon Barao. Nice trip takedown. Philip Norris looking exhausted and does not know where the hell he is. Hannon Barao is doing it all today, making it work. Beautiful coverage. Wraps the legs. Gets. This is not mount, but yeah, this is more like bottom half. Philip Norris trying to get up. But he still has got the body lock. Hannon Barao has got a strong body lock.
Okay, Hen and Barao abandons the takedown and says, let's stand and bang. Hen and Barao now trying to not engage that much. Philip Noor standing there. Okay, Hen and Barao slowing down a little bit. Oh, nice jumping double knee by Philip. Nice knee to the body by Henan. Going for the clinch work. Pushing him up against the cage. Did he get the body lock? No, he did not get the body lock. But he's still pushing for it. Pushing for a takedown. They reset to the center. And with almost 2 minutes remaining, Philip Noor has to go for broke, pretty much, in order to win this fight. Both guys are slowing down considerably, but Philip Noor is going for the knockout KO overall. Nice 1-2 by Henan. The speed advantage is definitely with Henan Barao. And power is almost identical for both men. Nice knees to the body in the clinch by Henan. Oh, nice elbows by Philip Noor. Beautiful elbows. Henan Barao is slowing down considerably. Do not know what has happened. But Henan Barao's gas tank is looking suspicious right now. Philip Noor is energized again and he is winning the fight right. Oh, nice overhand right by Henan. Resets to the center. Nice knee to the body again by Henan. 55 seconds remaining. Henan Barao just escaping from the scruff of the neck. Oh, nice knee to the body again by Henan. Philip Noor is not tiring, but looks like Henan is. Oh, goes for a Superman punch, Philip Noor, but ends up getting partially taken down and controlled by Henan Barao. They're on their knees near the cage. But good pressure by Henan. 15 seconds remaining. He does not have to worry about anything much. Even if he loses this round, I think he won the fight. Okay, beautiful takedown again. Gets his back almost. Last 10 seconds remaining. Can he get in the choke? No, looks like he doesn't. And we have a conclusion to the co-main event of the evening. Philip Noor is celebrating for some reason. I do not know why, but clearly Henan Barao. Clearly Henan Barao won. Let's see the comment section. Oh, that's okay. Hi, it's okay. Barao won probably. Looks like Henan Barao clearly won this fight. 29-28 in my book for sure. Maybe 130-27 because this is in Brazil and anything can happen. Cyborg cut a lot of weight for this camp, man. That could be a factor in the main event. Who knows what's gonna happen? Co-main event decision is gonna come up very, very soon, in about 15-20 seconds. I feel Henan Barao won that fight. Let me know who you got in the comment section. JD Hunting. Oh, thank you. Savior always. Okay, Savior always. Get the weed going. Good job there. Anyway, so decisions are almost here. Bruce Buffer is ready. Let's see whether we have any surprises here. should be a 29-28 for sure. Catchweight fight at 140 is gonna come up next. The main event, Cris Cyborg Justino versus Lina Elbow Queen Lansberg. Before that, we have the official decision. Can I crank it up? So the Baron, Renan Barao, wins the decision 29-28 on two judges and 30-27 on one judge. That is pretty unanimous. Yeah, it's been a good fight card. Forrest French. When is UFC 205? That is on November 12th. That is UFC 205. Barao with the decision. Our dreamer's birthday is on November 11th, all right. So we got the co-main event covered and done and dusted. Now we're ready for the real fight. Now we're ready for the money fight. Lina Lansberg versus Cris Cyborg. Cyborg destroys human beings. Not just girls, human beings. She's got amazing power in her hands. Last four fights have been first round knockouts or TKOs for Cris Cyborg. Plus, Lina Lansberg is a relative newcomer to mixed martial arts. She is just 6-1. She lost her first MMA fight, looked pretty bad, but has put together a 6-fight win streak in order to get into the UFC. And this is one of the few times where a debuting fighter like Lina Lansberg is on the main event of a fight night card. Very, very rare that it has happened. Yeah, Bigfoot's really going slow these days. But the surprising part is that Roy Nelson is 3 years older than Bigfoot. Bigfoot's still 37. He can bring it back. But I don't think he is that much into it. He just doesn't have that same spark which he used to have back in the day. That's just my personal opinion there. But Roy Nelson's still keeping it strong at 40, man. These 40 plus heavyweights, Mark Hunt, Roy Nelson, these guys are still doing it. Next week, though, we have got a banging card coming up for you guys. John Lineker versus John Dodson. That's going to be a crazy stand-up war in the UFC 135-pound division for the men. Both of these guys are crazy knockout artists, but I feel John Dodson has more power in his hands compared to John Lineker. But John Lineker's nickname is Hands of Stone. So don't underestimate that guy too. Yep, Sambak DD is correct. Lina has no titties? Seriously? Let me check. She does have it, but it's nothing major though. Why are we talking about looks here? It's gonna be a fight and Cyborg is probably gonna destroy her. I just hope that Lina Lansberg doesn't bleed so much that her face becomes unrecognizable.
That's my only concern, because unless there's a freak knockout from Lina Lansberg's end, Cyborg is going to walk away with this one. That's my opinion. What do you guys think? There are some Lina Lansberg lovers here, though I do agree it is possible, similar to Holly Holm knocking out Ronda Rousey, but that's a very, very distant thought at this moment. Yep, age has got nothing to do with your chin if your chin is weak. Definitely, I agree to that. So, all ready for the main event, but quick update for next week's stream. John Lineker versus John Dodson. John Dodson is number 10 in bantamweight, and John Lineker is number 3. Both of those guys are fighting. TJ Dillashaw is number 1. Asun Sao is number 2. And the champion is doing commentary for Fox Sports today. Dominic Cruz is the UFC bantamweight champion, who would probably face the winner of this particular fight. There is a good possibility of that happening. So that might be a really interesting fight to see. TJ versus Cody. Yeah, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah, they should probably do TJ versus Cody, and then the winner of TJ Cody should fight the winner of Lineker Dodson. Probably, or they might even give them the direct title shot. Yeah, TJ Cody winner should probably get the title shot. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are finally ready for Lina Lansberg's debut and Cris Cyborg's second UFC fight. First fight was in UFC 198 against Leslie Smith, and she destroyed her in one round. This fight is also in Brazil, and probably she might destroy her. But if you look at both of these gentlemen, sorry, I looked at Cyborg there, not gentlemen, gentlewoman. Lina Lansberg is definitely the better looking fighter. For sure. I have to agree with the comments, though. Lina Lansberg is better looking than Cris Cyborg. If you look at Cris Cyborg, she pretty much says, like, you know what, fuck this, I'm gonna kill you. That's that kind of face that Cris Cyborg has. Lina Lansberg, on the other hand, has got a decent midriff and decently good face. But this is mixed martial arts. This is the UFC, and faces has got nothing to do with it. Her stand-up looks very basic. Lina Landsberg's stand-up from her previous fights. The way she throws her kick is not the way you're supposed to throw it. Her hands are slightly better, but still could have been better, though. But Cyborg has got a great chin, though. Why are we still talking about titties here? Anyways, are we ready, people? Hopefully you're ready, because Lina Lansberg is about to enter the octagon. According to Art Dreamer, she has no titties. According to me, she does. I mean, a little bit of whatever is there in there, inside somewhere. You gotta search for it. I mean, there's a saying in my country, if you search hard enough, you can even find God. So I don't think it's going to be a big problem in finding Lina Landsberg's titties there. If you search for it, you will find it somewhere there. All right. So let's not talk about her titties there. Let's talk about her fighting style. She's predominantly a Muay Thai fighter. Seems to use her elbow more compared to her punches, and looks decent on the ground, not very good, But power is a major difference between Lansberg and Cyborg. Cyborg lands with devastating power. Yeah, Gabby Garcia does not look good. She looks like a man with a wig. And she's huge. She is 50 pounds heavier than me. For sure. But yeah, Cyborg looks better than Gabby Garcia. So that settles the looks department for sure. Anyways, Lina Lansberg is all happy that she's making her UFC debut. She's all calm and collected. Somebody's taking off her t-shirt. Yeah, it's in there somewhere. It's in there. So that should be her husband or boyfriend, right? Anyways, Lina Landsberg's face is pretty much spotless. And if Cyborg lands on that pretty face, phew, it's gonna be trouble. It's gonna be trouble. Oh, thank you so much, JD's Hunting and Fishing. That is very kind of you. Valentina is good too. Valentina fights good too. Let's focus on that for a moment. 6-fight win streak, world Muay Thai champion. And this is her UFC debut, Lina Elbow Queen Lansberg. So these days, the UFC has got women referees doing the checking of the fighters. Lansberg is pretty pumped for her debut. She's praying. She went up 3 times to the heavens upstairs, praying that Cyborg does not kill her in the next 3 minutes, hopefully. I'm just kidding. Who knows, man? And surprise is going to be there. Rodrigo Barao, you can watch this on Sony ESPN, Sony 6, BT Sport, GD Sport, CTV, TSN, RDS, TV3 channel, Combate in South America, 70 Sports, SPO TV, Hyper TV. These are the links where you can watch this fight on. These are the channels where you can watch this fight on. Have made a spreadsheet of this today morning. And I will put it up on my next stream so that you guys can join me in watching all of these fights with me as we break down all UFC mixed martial arts fights at MMA Live. So once again, if you're tuning in, we are ready for the main event. Fox Sports Africa, BT Sports, Hyper TV, SPO TV, Sony ESPN, and Sony 6. These are the top channels on cable or on the internet. You can watch this on XBMC or Kodi. And you would be able to watch all of these fights. The crowd is going bananas for Cris Cyborg. She just ran into the octagon. She looks pretty serious though. She cut a lot of weight for this one. She did not have a good weight cut. If this fight goes late, it will be really interesting. Pray for Lina, legendary Brian, with the comment. That shirt is coming off. All right, let's see. Let's see. Lina, don't get her. Please stay beautiful. The comments are amazing. Cyborg is about to enter. Yeah, the only problem which I see here is if Cyborg had a very bad weight cut, which looked like she did, she might get tired very soon. So if Lina Lansberg can survive one round with Cyborg, it's possible she gets a decision. But Cyborg is unbeaten in her last 17 fights. Now, think about that, people. 17 fights undefeated. Her only loss was to a great Muay Thai stand-up fighting girl. I forget her name, but that was her only loss. Apart from that, Cris Cyborg is spotless in her record, and she has probably the least amount of fight time in the women's division, probably after Ronda Rousey. Her average fight time is 5 minutes in her entire professional career. Here we go, people. Main event is here. Cris Cyborg is 31. Lina Lansberg is 34. Okay. Her reach, Lina Lansberg, 65.5 inches. And Cris Cyborg has a 68-inch reach. So 3-inch reach advantage for Cyborg and 3 years younger. So Cyborg is younger, more powerful, and has a bigger reach. That should give you a clear indication. As I've already promised you guys, if Cyborg loses, I will take my shirt off. As I promised to JT in the evening, sorry, in the morning earlier today. So that doesn't look like it. But JT, let's see what you're going to do if Lina Lansberg loses. Can we have a bet on that? The main event, the crowd is going bananas, man. I don't expect this to go beyond one round, for sure. It's time, as Bruce Buffer says. Catchweight fight at 140 pounds, Lina Lansberg, called as the Elbow Queen. She does not look 34 years old at all. She's a plus 650 underdog. Wow, that is one of the highest underdog bets I've seen in a while. 650 plus is a lot of odds against you. Lina Lansberg is the Elbow Queen. She prayed 3 times to the heaven. I don't know what she prayed for, but I hope she prayed for victory. They're introducing Cris Cyborg. 16 victories, 1 loss, 1 no contest, minus 1,100 favorite. That is one of the biggest favorite odds also I've seen in a long time. Minus 1,100. That means you make $1 if you bet 10 or something like that. That's approximately what you make. If you bet $1,000, you make 1,100. Cris Cyborg, the crowd is going nuts. Brazil is already chanting, "You va morrer." That means Lina Landsberg's probably going to die. Will they touch gloves? Lina Lansberg looks cute, man. I don't want her to die, that's all. That is all. The crowd is chanting "Yua Mohe," like I can hear it. Hopefully, let me increase max volume. Oh, nice moment by Lina Lansberg. Cris Cyborg. Cyborg has to be careful. Nice punches by Cyborg, nice knees. Oh, nice clinching by Lina Lansberg. Okay, this wasn't expected. She's having her clinch pretty strong. Can she go for a takedown? Nice knee to the body by Cyborg. Cyborg has to disengage here and go for the punches. Otherwise, Cyborg will get tired. Lina Lansberg is pretty strong for her clinch. Nice knees to the body by Lina Lansberg. Man, Cyborg is so much bigger. 1 minute already over. This fight is going fast. No, I do not understand why Cyborg is going for the clinch game. She has much better power. She cannot tire herself out.
The underhooks by Lina are pretty strong. Oh, nice elbow by Lina. Oh, nice punch by Cyborg. The underhooks of Lina are very strong. It's very surprising to see that she's able to engage Cyborg like this in the clinch. Oh, nice punches. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Cyborg is unleashing on Lina Lansberg, but Lina Lansberg clinches again with Cyborg. 3 minutes up. Man, Cyborg throws for destruction. Oh, going for a trip takedown. But Cyborg recovering. Pressure from Cyborg. This is a very technical fight, though. Do I have to take my shirt off? Really? What the fuck, man? Oh, nice punches by Cyborg again. Knees to the body coming in. Thick and strong for Cyborg. Oh, nice takedown defense by Cyborg. Cyborg is spending a lot of energy defending the takedowns. Not a lot of action. But Lina Lansberg still surviving 2 minutes in. Nice jab by Cyborg. Oh, nice punches by Cyborg again. So Lina Lansberg game plan is going for the clinch. Going for the clinch and trying to avoid damage and take it late into the fight. That is her game plan. Okay. Oh, beautiful takedown by Cyborg. Beautiful underhooks. Mount for Cyborg. This is not looking good for Lina. This is not looking good for Lina. Oh my goodness. No. This is Cyborg territory, man. Getting punched in the face. Can she go for a rear naked? Half guard. Nice recovery by Lina. Lina Lansberg is tough. Nice knee to the body by Cyborg again. These knees are coming in thick and fast. But it's very appreciable that Lina Lansberg survived the round. It's very appreciable. Oh, nice punches by Cyborg. Uh-oh, it's about to be over. No, she recovers. Lina Lansberg somehow recovers. 10 seconds remaining. Can Cyborg finish this? Oh, nice elbow. Nice elbow by Lina. Okay, round comes to an end. That was a clear round in favor of Cyborg. But Lina Lansberg survived. It's really surprising, though. After a long time, somebody has made it out of one round for Cyborg. I did not know why Cyborg was clinching so much, but maybe that's part of a strategy. That's a lot of good work by Cyborg. But if Cyborg gets tired, man, it's going to be really interesting if Cyborg gets tired. It's going to be really interesting. Looks like Lina Landsberg's recovered. The clinch game of Lina Landsberg is actually really solid. Stalking. Cyborg is stalking her. Round two. Oh, nice punch by Cyborg. Oh, nice kick to the body. Oh my goodness, the barrage. The kicks to the body. Lina Lansberg is surviving. Oh, punches. Cyborg, don't gas out, man. Don't gas out. Lina Lansberg can take a punch. Wow. How is Lina Lansberg surviving? Oh, reversal of position by Lina. Can she go for some elbows? Oh, nice punch. Oh, Lina Lansberg with a nice punch to the body. Nice reversal by Cyborg. Oh, beautiful takedown by Cyborg. Beautiful takedown by Cyborg. From the clinch. Nice reversal. Oh, is she going for an arm triangle? Oh, nice punches by Cyborg. You should not get caught by a submission there. Nice tacking. Nice punches by Cyborg. Lina Lansberg is sticking around here, man. Nice elbows by Cyborg to the elbow queen herself. Oh, this is about to be done. This is about to be done. This is about to be done. She is not defending herself that well. Lot of damage done by Cyborg through those punches. Lina Lansberg is cut. She is bleeding. This fight is about to be done. And it is all over. Cris. Cyborg wins by TKO. It is all over. Cyborg by destruction. Beautiful, beautiful fight by Cyborg. She stayed patient. She stayed patient. And ground and pound, eventually getting the better of Lina Lansberg. But Lina Lansberg face is messed up though. A lot of heart by Lina Lansberg. A lot of heart. Much respect, man. Much respect for Lina Lansberg. Good stoppage by the referee. Great, great stoppage by the referee. Cris Cyborg, man, I told you. JT Hunting. This shirt is not coming off after all, huh? Hey, Sambak. Lina Lansberg was not a tin can as such, alright? Now, if you really look at it, who are they going to give? Ronda Rousey does not want to fight Cris Cyborg. Holly Holm doesn't want to fight Cris Cyborg. Miesha Tate doesn't want to fight Cris Cyborg at 140. So what are they going to do? They have to find people who want to fight Cris Cyborg. That's the problem here. Give Cyborg her belt at 145, man. She deserves it. At least after today, after cutting weight to 140. Lina Lansberg was okay with doing this fight at 145. People, listen to this. Lina Lansberg said she was okay to do this at 145. The UFC
forced Cyborg to do this at 140. There was no need for it. They could have done it at 145. I do not know what the UFC is trying to achieve by making Cyborg cut so much weight. I think it's time Cyborg gets her own division, man. They handed the belt to Rousey at 135. And I think Cyborg pretty much deserves the same, man, if not more. Another vintage performance by Chris Cyborg, man, by destruction, ground and pound, with the nose broken. Man, Lina Lansberg's nose is bleeding. Chris Cyborg, winner by TKO, second round, 2 minutes 29 seconds. The crowd is going nuts. Lina Lansberg and Cyborg hug each other. A lot of respect for both people. Wow, that was a fight night, ladies and gentlemen. That was a great night of fights. Whew, 2 hours, 30 minutes into it, and I'm still pumped. Though the timing was a little off for today, still feel one of the better fight nights. All the fights, if I'm not wrong, all the fights in the main card were finishes, which is except Barao versus Nover. So all the other fights were finishes, which is really commendable for a fight night. So that fight night pulled in a lot of numbers. Thank you all for joining into the stream. Do like and subscribe the channel. We do this every week, every UFC fight. We break it down for you people. Do subscribe, show me some love. This is Harry from MMA Live, signing off for today. Adios, amigos. See you soon. Ta-da.